Welcome to another Silent Rob rant. And the first thing I want to talk about is where every single movie that's coming out lately seems to be heading. And that's 3D. Did anybody actually ask for this fucking bullshit? Does anybody really care if their movies are in 3D? Does it really make the movies better if they are in three dimensions than if they're in two dimensions? I don't know about you guys, but I had no problem watching movies in 2D. All the movies I've ever liked, every movie I've ever grown up with, has been in 2D. And never have I been watching a movie like Saving Private Ryan or Lord of the Rings and been sitting there thinking, wow, this movie's good, but it'd be a lot better if it was in 3D. Bullshit, okay? The whole idea of 3D is a good idea, okay? People, even back in the 50s, thought 3D was a good idea. But here's the problem. We've never been able to perfect it to make it anything more than a gimmick. And at this point in time, that's what it is. It's a fucking gimmick. It's a way to get even more money out of your pockets when you go to the movie theater. We're talking upwards of $15 per ticket just to see one fucking movie. And certain movies get it right. Movies like Avatar and stuff are good in 3D. But that's the exception and not the rule, okay? Movies like Clash of the Titans in 3D are abysmal. They're failures, okay? They're movies that weren't made to be in 3D in the first place and are presented in 3D. A slapdash 3D technique that's presented on the movies after they're already made to make them into the fucking bullshit 3D that they are today. And it seems to be popular. Everybody seems to be liking 3D, and every movie is being made that way. Here's the question I present to you. Does anybody else not like 3D movies at all? Not for the fact that, you know, they don't really look very good, but to me, they give me a fucking headache. They make my fucking eyes hurt, they give unnecessary strain to your eyes, and they make your head hurt because, basically, you're having to wear these glasses and you're having to contort your eyes and trick your brain into seeing a 3D image for upwards of 2.5 hours. Movies like Avatar are just totally unenjoyable to some people, including me, because of the way 3D is presented. If they're going to have this technology, they need to do it in a way that isn't eye-straining, and that's a little bit cheaper than what it actually is. I'm not fucking paying these prices anymore, okay? I'm seeing every new movie that comes out in 2D, the way it needs to be, the way it's always been. Back in the 50s, this 3D shit took off, and there's a reason why it died out, because it's fucking stupid, okay? These movies aren't really 3D. You ain't tricking anybody. Half the effects look like dog shit, okay? Unless the movies have actual budgets at an Avatar level, don't even bother because it doesn't look good. I see all these new movies coming out like, you know, Piranha and, you know, even movies that don't even really need to be 3D, like How to Train Your Dragon, where it is a good animated movie, but does it need to be 3D? Fuck no, it doesn't need to be 3D. Would it be just as good in 2D? Fuck yes, it'd be just as good in 2D. My brother just bought Avatar on Blu-ray, and it was amazing, okay? It was even better than in the theater, because it didn't hurt your eyes. You weren't looking for things jumping out of the screen. It was just the way a movie was meant to be presented. In beautiful 1080p on my fucking TV, it looked great. There's just no reason for it. Until the technology comes up to the ambition, let's do away with this fucking 3D bullshit. Now let's talk about movie sequels for a minute. I already talked about horror movie remakes, and to be honest, I don't hate sequels as much as remakes, but at the same time, I think sequels are ruining Hollywood. They're ruining the film industry at the same time they're actually saving it. And what do I mean by that is this. Whenever a movie is released, like a big blockbuster movie, they're always looking at ways to make a sequel. And if your movie is made where there cannot be a sequel, most of the time it's not going to be as heavily promoted as a movie that has grounds for a franchise. The trouble is, most of the time, sequels to good movies suck ass. There really aren't very many good sequels, and there's even less sequels that are actually better than the original. As a matter of fact, the only sequels that I can think of that are actually better than the original are Dawn of the Dead, Aliens, Terminator 2, Godfather 2, Evil Dead 2, Star Trek 2, Empire Strikes Back, The Dark Knight, and The Road Warrior. Those are the only ones I can actually think of off the top of my head. Granted, there might be more, and granted, that list is my opinion. The first Alien movie was a great movie. The first Terminator movie was a great movie. You know, Night of the Living Dead was a great movie. These all might be your favorite movies. But in a lot of people's eyes, those movies are better than the originals. But at the same time, those movies are the exception and not the rule. Most of the time, sequels suck ass. Movies such as Alien 3, for example. Movies such as Godfather 3, for example. Most of the time, sequels can actually ruin a movie. It can actually make the original movie bad. Movies such as Hostel 2, like, I loved the first Hostel movie by Eli Roth, but in my eyes, Hostel 2 actually ruined Hostel 1 for me. The way Hostel 2 actually began ruined everything about the ending in the first one, thus ruining the first movie for me. And there are other examples of this. There are even sequels that almost ruin an entire franchise. Movies such as Superman 3 and 4, the Joel Schumacher Batman movies, Jurassic Park 3, Jaws 2, all these movies almost completely ruined the entire franchises. I mean, it took Superman more than 10 years to recover from Superman 4. The Batman movies almost completely died out after fucking Batman and Robin. I mean, honestly, I would say that sequels actually hurt movies more than they actually help them. There are even movies that don't need sequels, but sequels are made for them anyways, just to cash in on the original's name. Movies such as Starship Troopers, one of my personal favorite movies, had a direct-to-video bullshit fucking sequel made for it that was god-awful and had nothing to do with the original Starship Troopers. Movies such as RoboCop and The Matrix. Did The Matrix really need a sequel? I mean, if you watch The Matrix from beginning to end, it really doesn't need a sequel. It pretty much ties everything up, and you can pretty much use your imagination on what's going to happen next. And it's not like the sequels even, you know, made the first one better. It didn't, okay? Same thing goes with RoboCop. RoboCop did not need a sequel. You know, granted, RoboCop 2 wasn't that bad, but if there wasn't RoboCop 2, then we wouldn't have gotten the piece of shit that was RoboCop 3. So, somebody has to be responsible for this shit. And it has to stop somewhere, okay? We can't just be making these sequels forever. This shit is getting out of hand.